let's get on with the problems now. Okay. Chalo, solve this problem, the class exercise. So you can see whenever we have a calculation like this, what do we do? We use your method wherein product is taken care of first. So 12 into 100 is done first, 5 into 100 is done here, and 6 into 1. So basically 12 into 100 is 1200 plus 5 into 10 is 50 plus 6 into 1 is 6. We add them up, we got 1256. Now 1256 is, now I want to check the first option 2 and 3. Now is this number divisible by 2? Yes, it is divisible by 2 because it's an even number. Is it divisible by 3? Now we know some of the numbers. 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 5 is 8, 8 plus 6 is 14. And that 14 is not divisible by 3. The divisibility rule of 3, if you remember, the sum should be divisible by 3. Therefore, the number is not divisible by 3. Now, because it's divisible by 2 and not by 3, I know answer A cannot be my answer. Now, I need not even check for B. I can also say that C cannot be my answer because it's not divisible by 2, it's not divisible by 3, it is definitely not divisible by 6. Because we learned for a number to be divisible by 6, it should be divisible by both 2 and 3. Therefore, option C cannot be the answer and option D also cannot be the answer. Therefore, without checking anything, I can say B is the answer. Not every time that you are lucky like this. At times you need to check also. Now let's check whether it is divisible by 4 and 8. How do we do it? Now we have 1256. We have 1256. What is the divisibility rule for 4? How do we check for 4? We check for the last digits. So is 56 divisible by 4? Yes, it is divisible by 4. Yes, 56 is divisible by 4. Therefore, it's divisible. How do we check for 8? We check the last three digits, 256. Now is 256 divisible by 8? Yes, 8 threes are 24, 1 carryover is 16, 8 twos are. So 256 is divisible by 8. Therefore, 1256 is divisible by both 4 and 8. Therefore, your answer is option B. Let's go ahead. Solve this.
So the answer is 4.
Neha, now you can explain. Go ahead.
That's because I can explain it with examples. Because first we can take the smallest or numbers as 1 and 3. So 1 plus 3 is 4. And then the next four numbers are 3 and 5. And 3 plus 5 is 8, which is in the table of 4. And 5 and 7, 5 plus 7 is 12, which is in the table of 8. So I, which is in the table of 4. So I came to the answer, it's 4.
Wonderful. So you know what Neha has done is she picked up a couple of examples of two consecutive odd natural numbers. She picked up 1 and 3, she got 4. 3 and 5, she got 8. 5 and 7, she got 12. So 4, 8 and 12, all these numbers, when you keep on going like this, all these numbers will, these 4, 8, 12, is that divisible by 7? No, it's not divisible. Is it divisible by 3? No, it is not. Now, is it divisible by 8? Now, yes, this number is divisible by 8, but this is not divisible by 8. This is also not divisible by 8. So any two consecutive odd natural numbers, if you take up, they will definitely be divisible by 4 because any two you can take. Say, for example, you take 11 and 13. 11 and 13. What is 11 and 13? 24. Now, 11 plus 13 is 24. Is 24 divisible by 4? Yes. But whereas if you take something like, say, 13 plus 15. Now, 13 plus 15 is how much? 28. Now, this 28 is also divisible by 4. Whereas it is not divisible by 8. Whereas 24 is divisible by 8, but 28 is not divisible. So all, if you take any two consecutive odd natural numbers, they are definitely divisible by 4. For you to understand that trend, you have to take a couple of examples. What Neha did is she took 1 plus 3, and similarly she took 3 plus 5. Then she got the trend. She can clearly see that those numbers are definitely divisible by 4. That's the reason answer is C. Okay, very good. Come on, solve this. This is the last problem for the day, and we'll end the class with this. Now, x is a composite number such that x is equal to a power p into b power q, where a and b are the first two prime numbers. So x is equal to a to the power of p into b to the power of q, and he's saying that a and b are the first two prime numbers. Now, what are the first two prime numbers? We know what are the first two prime numbers. 2 is the first prime number that we know, and 3 is the another prime number that we know. So basically, x is nothing but 2 to the power of p and 3 to the power of q. But do you know the value of p and q? No, this is a real Olympiad question. This is a very good question. All of you, if you are able to follow this, it's a very good question. Now, 2 to the power of p into 3 to the power of q. But to calculate the value of p and q, he told you that p plus q is 8, p plus q is 8, and pq is 15. No. Once again, this requires observation. Now, we have learned factor. Yeah.
Sir, I guess p is 5 and q is 3.
Okay, very good. It could be like that. It could be like that. P could be 5, q could be 3. Or it could be the other way around also.
It could, so be, it could be 4 plus 4.
No, 4 plus 4 is not right, because 4 plus 4 is 8, but 4 into 4 is not 15, right? 4 fours are 16.
Oh, yes, sorry, sir.
So it could be 5, 3, or it could be 3 and 5. Is everyone, yes, getting sir. It? Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Now, so therefore, basically, the answer could be 2 power 5. Into 3 power 3, or answer could be 2 power 3 into 3 power 5. It could be this, or it could be this. But if you calculate, this answer is equal to 864. That's the reason, that is your right answer. Now, do you want a better way of solving this? So let me teach you to solve this without doing anything like this. Let me explain. Concentrate, everyone, all of you, please concentrate. I'll use a different color of the pen to explain this method. Now, x is given as a power p into b power q. So x is equal to a, you know, it is, he has told you it's first two primes. It's 2 to the power of p into 3 to the power of q. So you know it is the multiple of 2 and a multiple of 3. That means your x should be divisible by both 2 and 3. We have learned divisibility rules in the class today. Can I say that x should be divisible by both 2 and 3? Therefore, it should be, we have to check for divisibility rule of 2 and 3. Let's check. 868, it's divisible by 2, but is it divisible by 3? No. Therefore, this cannot be my answer. Can you get that? Similarly, I'll come to this later. Let's check this. 8 plus 2 is 10. 10 plus 7 is 17. Even this is not divisible by 3. Therefore, this also cannot be my answer. 856. 8 plus 5 is 13 plus 6, 19. Even this is not divisible by 3. Therefore, these three cannot be my answer. From the given options, this is the only option that is divisible by 3 as well as 2. Therefore, that's my answer. If there were to be two options which are divisible by 2 and 3, then you could have checked for 4, because it is 2 to the power of p and 3 to the power of q. So here p could be multiples of 2, right? 2 into 2. So because here you know p plus q is 8 and pq is 15. So here you know p is minimum 3 or 5. So that is required. You will use it only if required. Otherwise, this is another way of solving this. I am not asking you to solve it like this. I'm just giving you how to think. So this is the right approach. What we did first, what Neha did, is the right approach to problem solving. But I also want you to understand that when you have in Olympiad kind of exams wherein options are given to you, you should know how to think differently. So we have learned divisibility rules. We have applied how to use divisibility rules in this given options.